and welcome to another episode of Do Cross TV. On today's show, we've got the very talented Becky James, who's going to be showing us how to make some origami flowers. But before we get to that, I want to show you a new die set from Xcut. It's part of the Builder Scene range. And as you can see, you've got these lovely village scenes, which are great for your Christmas cards, but also for things like weddings, because you've got a lovely church or someone who's moving into a new home. It's really versatile. And to match, you've got the Papermania A5 clear stamp set, and that's got all your detail to stamp on top of your scene. You can also use them on their own if you prefer, but you've got little things like a little cat, a little man walking his dog, to really add that detail to your scene. So make sure to look out for these in your local Docrafts stockist. Hi Becky, thanks for coming down today.
Hi Sarah, lovely to be here.
So what are you doing for us?
Well, today we are going to make this rather pretty paper-folded lily.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
So I've just turned it into a corsage as well. And we're using the beautiful new Capsules Jewels papers. Yeah. So I'm actually starting with, what I've done is I've cut, these are A4, so I've cut it to make a square with the A4.
Okay.
The A4 size. So, and because these are nice heavyweight papers, you do need to use quite a sizable starting piece. Yeah. Anyway, so we're going to start first of all with our pattern facing us. And we're going to fold the two sides against each other. So what I need to do as well with this is I need a good paper creaser, and I've got the new X-cut creasers here. They're a nice heavyweight sort of chunky plastic, and they're perfect for making sure that you've got a good crease whilst you're doing this.
That's very important for this kind of project, I imagine.
Right, so what I've done is I've actually made quarters now. So what I'm going to do is turn the paper over, and it's really important you do turn the paper over because you're going to get your folds in the right place.
Yeah.
And we're going to go corner to corner this time. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take two of the trough folds and fold it in so I get a nice big triangle here, like this. And there's actually a mark, a line down the centre of that triangle. And what we're going to do is take each corner out here and fold it in towards the centre. And again, I'm just going to give it a good crease.
Yeah.
And you need to do that going both ways, so to the centre on the onto the next, the other way as well, because that will make sure that your paper is going to move nicely when you want to fold it. So we're just going to work round, and there's four of these, so we're just going to work round and do all four. Right, now what I'm going to do is, now I'm here at this stage, I'm going to open this one out so that it gives me a nice diamondy sort of pattern here. And I'm going to do that at the front and at the back. And so we're going to do the front and the back first, and then we'll work on these two sides afterwards.
Okay.
Okay. So the next thing that we need to do, and I'll just show this to the camera, is we're going to take this corner and fold it into the centre line on both sides.
Okay.
So I'll just fold that in. And you will see some of the paper, if you've got double-sided papers or if you've got white, you will see some of the underneath come through now. So you will start to see that.
Yeah.
Now what I'm going to do here, if I just show, is I'm going to take this corner and fold it down to this corner. So we're going to fold it in half.
Okay.
And that, some of these folds don't actually show up so much in the finished pattern, but what they do is they allow other bits to be folded into more unusual shapes, I suppose. So we're going to do that. Then what we're going to do is take this point here and fold it up to the point at the top. And you then bring the bits, the centre, these little bits back down here. And what I like to do is get my paper creaser and get it right in here, so it makes sure that all those, you get some nice, all your paper doesn't sort of crease up in.
Yeah.
It's nice and crisp through there.
That's what's great about those tools. You can use them for so many different ways.
Absolutely. In fact, once you know what you're doing, for instance, with this one side, it's following it through four times. Right, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold those two bits that I've done already, and we're going to open these diamonds out from the bits that are left over.
Yeah.
So we'll do that. And we're just going to repeat what we've just done to the other two sides. Right, so now what you've ended up with is a shape a little bit like a diamond like this, and you've got a smaller, it's like a smaller point down here and a longer one up here. Mm. So I'm going to have that in front of me with the smaller point facing me.
Okay.
And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull that towards me, pull this part of the triangle back towards me, and then you'd have to twist it round. And that twisting round is really important.
Okay.
Because otherwise you won't get your petals.
Don't forget to twist.
Don't forget to twist, that's it. So what I'm now going to do is actually, let me show you on the camera. I'm going to take this point here, because you've actually got an equilateral diamond here. Mm. It's half and half is they're symmetrical. I'm going to take this point here and fold this into the centre. So I'm just going to take that point there and again give it a good crisp. But you can see this is heavyweight paper.
Yeah.
You've really got to work with it, which is fine. It's really nice because you get a nice sturdy flower at the end of it. Now I'm going to fold that in like that and open up the next one of those triangles.
Okay.
And push that open. So we're just going to repeat that all the way around. Right, now then, having done that, if I open that up, these now are our petals. And what we're going to do is, I've actually got one of the LVCC dowels, which usually are used for putting the cakes together. For stacking the cakes. Because it's equal size all the way along, it's perfect for curling.
Yeah.
So all I'm going to do is just get my flower and curl it like that, and that will curl my petals. Now, I've actually pulled together a few little bits and pieces here. And believe it or not, this is the stem. It is actually made by winding the New Jewels gold spotted pattern craft tape round a pipe cleaner. So this is one of the Craft Planet ones. Really, really easy. It's nice and solid, so you're not going to have it sort of fold down or break down on you. And what I've got here is a button, and we're actually going to stick, I've got a button here, and we're actually going to stick this onto the centre to make a decoration. Ooh. So what I need to do now is I'm going to have to put my stem through, so I'm just going to cut that off there, and that will allow me to pop that just down there. And I can, if I just sort of hold and have a look where I want my centrepiece to be. And we're just going to wrap that round with some pattern craft tape.
And this is all from the Jewels collection.
From the Jewels collection. This is actually the purple one that I've got here, which is a little bit wider. And once you've got it where you want it to be, if once you're happy with where it is, you want it to stick permanently, just pop a bit of tacky glue or a bit of hot melt glue underneath, and it will hold it in place. So, Sarah, what I'm now going to do is to pop some glue on the back of my button. And stick that on a little, I've actually made like a little platform for it, a little standby twisting around the edge of the pipe cleaner.
Yeah.
So we're going to pop that there. And then all of these, we are just going to pop a little bit of glue on and stick these in place just inside. Now you can actually place them inside as well if you want to, but I like to just add a little bit of glue to the end. So there you go. So now we've got all the central bits in place. It looks like a proper flower with all the stems and the stamens coming out. So just to turn it into a corsage, we've got a couple of little extra bits to finish off with. First of all, I've die cut some leaves out of green card, and that's using this shape die, which is a really useful one. It's a very generic sort of leaf shape.
That's the leaf nesting die from
Nextcut. Yes, leaf nesting die. And the first thing I'm going to do, actually, I'm just going to curl it back a bit.
Trusty dowling rod.
Yeah, indeed. In the same way that I did with the petals. And then I'm just going to fold so that it's got like a little vein down there. So we're going to make a couple of those. Right, now then, the final little thing we're going to do is add a bow and a button detail.
It's that gorgeous teal
colour. It is. This is one of the assorted ribbon packs, and it's got beautiful reds, which actually is on the one that we've already made up. It's got reds, it's got browns, it's got absolutely beautiful colour, lovely gold as well.
Very luxurious, isn't it? Very kind of stylish.
It is. It is indeed. That's exactly it, Sarah. And you know, actually suitable for so many occasions.
Mm.
Really is. Right, so we've popped a little bit of ribbon round. Now, if you want to as well, I'm just going to trim off a bit of this, but just especially if it's a buttonhole or something like that. It's nice to have, and quite often the florist will put a little bit of twine around or something like that, so that's quite a nice little detail, so we're going to do that. Right, last little thing, nice big sort of flamboyant bow. Take that, put some glue on it. I'm just going to use that to cover where I've put the twine at the front where the glue is.
Yeah.
I'm just going to take these scissors and cut in a V. There we go.
I guess you could always make the stem longer if you wanted to make lots and put it in a vase.
Absolutely. And that's exactly what you do. In fact, because I used about half of the stem for this, I would use a full stem if you want to put them in a vase.
You can get the extra long ones from Craft Planet as well if you do want to make them longer.
That's it. There we go. Just put some glue on. Pop that one on. And as you can see, I've kind of used all the colours that contrast with each other so that you've got a real vibrant look. And there you go.
That's gorgeous,
There's
Becky.
Your corsage.
Well, I hope this inspired you to have a go at some paper folding and some origami. It's really a fun craft to try. If you are inspired, send us your makes. We'd love to see them at tb@docrafts.com. We love sharing each other's creativity. So until next time, happy crafting.